Zoe.
How are you,
Zoe
Nick?
And Johnny, being naughty all the day long.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Lavender Hill Mobs Theatre Company Christmas Show Show. Hello, you pretty girl. Are you smiling at me? Sorry, that's my granddaughter. Right, today, we're not only going to entertain them, how is it?
Nope.
We're going to educate you. Do you like the sound of that? Are you sure? I think we're going to hear the sound half asleep. We'll start with a quick joke. Are you ready for a quick joke?
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
Yeah.
Europe.
Europe.
That's where we're starting. That's the level we're at now. We're going north. Oh, is that the mayor? I can see. You've got to open up an envelope, you, won't you, sweetheart? Your Highness. Welcome. Thank you for joining us today. Right. Zoe's going to set us off, aren't you, sweetie?
Yes. And we're going to start with A.
We're going to start with letter A.
Where else to start? A is for angels.
Is it?
Yep.
I've got this covered. Don't worry. Watch. Right, go on, Timmy! Watch, keep watching. Right, Smiley.
I didn't mean them kind of crackers.
Thank you anyway, darling. Alright.
You know, like pulley crackers.
Oh, no.
The first one was invented or made in 1840 by Thomas Smith.
Was it?
Yeah, and inside with a sugar-covered almond with messages of love.
Really?
I give up with you.
Would you want a sugar-coated almond with a message of love, right? Or would you rather have a little joke that nobody gets and a little pair of plastic nail clippers? Because I'd rather have the nail clippers, personally. Right, you might have noticed even that Zoe has disappeared. Because we've got our first piece of entertainment for you. With Zoe, are you waving or are you up, darling? You're up. Zoe and Alana Jade with Skyscraper. Give them a big round of applause.
Skies are crying, I am watching, catching teardrops in my head. Only silence as it's ending, like we never had a chance. Do you have to make me feel like there's nothing left of me? You can take everything I have, you can break everything I am, like I'm made of glass, like I'm made. As the smoke clears, I awaken and untangle you from me. Would it make you feel better to watch me while I bleed? All my windows still are broken, but I'm standing on my
Just have an epiphany.
Oh, that brings me on to E, the epiphany.
Shocker.
But was your epiphany about how it's bad luck to keep the decorations up past the 6th of January?
No.
Oh, for
Father Christmas! He's there! There he is! Oh, he, come on, jingle bells, everybody, do him. He's got sweeties, come on.
To promote the drink.
Flipping heck!
Sorry.
It's all right. Anyway, he's got the easiest job in the world, he has.
Why'd you say that?
He only works one day a year, doesn't he?
What does he do throughout the year?
I don't know. Should we go and have a look?
Let's have a look.
Let's have a look.
Christmas fair, but then they changed it to turkey.
Did they?
So he wasn't even half coached.
No, well, last year. year, I asked my mum for a dog for Christmas, and she said, no, you've got to have turkey like everyone else.
Where were you going?
I'm going down to the pub.
You meant all the same.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Hello, Sid. Usual?
Aye.
Have you had a word with Rita? You know? About economy?
Yes, I certainly have.
And?
I've got to give up smoking.
Whoa there, boy. Don't you understand? There's only three things a woman understands. Money, and more money. You know, my neighbours asked me, and she said, can I have 20 quid on Monday? Same on Tuesday. And blow me down, didn't she ask for another 20 on Wednesday? And every week's the same.
What does she do with all that money?
I don't know. I haven't given her any yet.
My missus always has her own way.
Really?
Yeah. She even writes it in her diary. Mumford.
How long you been wearing that there corset there, boy?
Ever since the wife found it in the car. She caught me glancing at that blonde. Two doors down. Hey, Sid, how is it that a woman can spot a blondette on a chap's coat? Yeah. Miss Garage Doors.
You got me there, boy. You got me there. It was only last month. Me and my neighbours had words. And I said to her, I'm going to join the Foreign Legion.
What did she say?
Her exact words were, I don't want you coming traversing that there son back in our house.
Harry's the lucky one. His wife is a complete angel.
He's lucky. Mine's still alive. Can't stay long, no boy. Mavis thinks I'm in the bar.
Yeah. Last time I was late home, Rita was standing by the door with a rolling pin in her hand. And I said to her, what are you doing baking at this time of night?
Come off it, boy. You're nothing but a weak spine. Spineless husband.
You wouldn't have the guts to say that if they were here.
You know, I've come to the conclusion, Bob, that there's only two reasons a man spends all night in this here pub. The first being, he's got no wife to go home. And the other, he has.
My dad once said, a marriage certificate is another name for a work permit.
I remember my dad telling me, he said, boy, if you're seen walking down the road holding hands with a girl before you're married, it's love. But our awards, it's in self-defense.
What was it that old Bert used to say? That's it. In the first year of marriage, the man speaks and the wife listens. In the second year, the wife speaks and the man listens. But then in the third year, they both speak. And the neighbours listen.
I love being married. It's so nice to find that one special person so you can annoy her for the rest of your life.
Did you hear about Ernie?
No.
He missed 2 maintenance payments last month, and his wife repossessed him.
Oh, you know, they do say you don't know the meaning of a true love of a woman until you have to pay the first maintenance payment. On that note, I think we better go.
Thanks, didn't it, to be fair? Yeah, a little bit, didn't it?
There's a brew in the pot. Ooh, I could do with this love. gossip. But I'll tell you this, but I can only tell you once, because I promise not to repeat it. You know her at number two? Well, she wears mud on her face, and she wears curlers.
No. I know why she bothers, you can still tell it's her.
Do you know what she said to me the other day? She told me that her husband had ran off with my best friend. Flipping it. Who was it? I don't know. I've never met her.
She's always moaning about him. I said, if you're that fed up with him, why don't you leave him?
Yeah, well, she's gone and done it now. He's probably gone off and joined the Foreign Legion.
She said she'd leave him if she could find a way of doing it without making him happy.
Yeah, well, probably did. Here, look at this recipe here, eh? Yeah. But you know, the trouble is that, well, she didn't trust him, and, well, he sure as hell didn't understand her.
It surprised me in the least. She told me she thought he was having an affair.
No! You don't give any of them to the pound.
All them.
Oh, don't. I've come over all unnecessary.
When I asked her what made her suspicious to his affair, she said, her last child don't resemble him in the least.
Well, what do you expect?
Possible for a man to make a fool of himself without knowing it?
Not if he's married and he's got a wife. No. I mean, you take my Sid. He wears the trousers, but I'll tell him which pair to wear.
My Bob's a man of fair gifts. He ain't give me one in years.
How is your Bob? Compared to what? Oh, you know what I mean. Do you know what? My Sid came home the other day. He's only gone and been sacked. Yep, sacked. Something to do with technology. He's been replaced by a gadget the size of a torch. It takes batteries. It does everything that a man can do. And it never wears out. Nothing. I went out to see if I could get one. Oh, dear. Oh, God. Yeah, you know what my motto is, gal. Never life, let life get you down. As one door closes, the other one slaps you in the face. You know, life's too short. You never get out of it alive.
Very true that, Mavis. By the time you're well off enough to eat, drink and be merry, the doctor limits you to a glass of milk and a spoon of yabby school.
Don't talk to me about doctors. Oh, do you know, I went to see my doctor the other week. I had a pain in my shoulder. Do you know what he said? Goggle it. I mean, since when have I known what technology and goggle is? Exactly. And then he had the audacity to turn around and say he was going to take away my pills. He said that they was habit forming. I told him, don't talk such rubbish. I've been taking them for years.
Is it that new one?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all tall teeth and long hair.
I went to him the other day. I was feeling quite run down and tired.
Yeah.
And he told me the remedy was simple.
What's that then?
Whatever I was doing, stop.
As a god of clue.
Body. Oh, lovely. Oh, can I have one of those?
Santa baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby. So how about the candy?
seen how long you stand in wings for.
Just waiting. I thought you'd got back of them cakes again.
No, I've got a little, I must admit, we've got to tell you this, right?
A little confession.
A little confession. Quite a big confession, actually. In the last sketch that you've just seen, the ladies had a, is it a cloche or whatever you call it, where you keep your cakes in?
Just a little tub, innit?
Yeah, they go like that, and that was 4 months, wasn't
it? I got a bit hungry in the wings.
Well, you know what I mean, but, you know, nobody's listening now, and we're amongst friends. I think we've bonded.
I'd say we bonded.
Do you want me to see if they've got any left? Do you fancy a cake?
Yeah.
You do? Liz! You can't make it. No, it's killing it. I'll try and sneak one out afterwards. Right. What are we up to? J.K.
L.
Look.
Look.
The kids today, you've got school. Look, it's for lollipop.
Nope.
Lazy.
Nope.
Lumbago.
No.
Labyrinth.
Yes. No.
It's for the Lord of Misrule.
Oh, that's me. I am the Lord of Misrule. No, don't stop looking at my skirt. She's looking at my dress. The Lord of Misrule.
Do you know what he does?
I haven't got a clue.
He plans the 12 days of Christmas, all the festivities, all the celebrations, everything.
Is it? See, now it's the wife, does it?
Yeah, pretty bog standard, that is.
Well, I think, see, now we've got to L.
I think it's time to take his break.
It says, I must have an acadou with a sit down.
L is the lady.
Is it? L is the lady. Now, the ladies should be needed. They're just
lazy.
For there. Oh, lazy. Oh, I thought you said ladies.
Nope, she said lazy.
You can't be lazy. You met me before. Right. So this is the reason why we're here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. These guys have been working so hard for the last, three, 4 months or so. And this is the whole point of this evening. Tonight, you are going to help Lavender Hill Mob Theatre Company to save Christmas. Enjoy.
She had the love of Christmas then.
was a very hands-on boss.
Mummy! Mummy! I want to sit on Father Christmas's knee!
No! You have to wait your turn!
But I've been a good boy, and I want to tell him what I want for Christmas!
Come on! My mum always told me that those that want don't get. I never want for anything. But I still don't get anything.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you make your final purchases as the shop will be closing early for staff training? Thank you for shopping at Kringle's.
Since when? Did you know there was a staff training? I was never told.
We're closing early due to a refit as the new proprietors want to bring the store up to date. Out with the old tat and greens, modern merchandise.
Surely they won't change everything. They won't get me a Santa.
Well, I wouldn't have thought so. He's the only decent Father Christmas in this shopping centre.
I wouldn't be so sure about that, as he's the first to go. We wouldn't be needing our help for this.
So if I were you, I'd take advantage of the early closing.
I don't know about you, but I don't need to tell him twice. Come on. Let's go do some retail therapy in the ladies' department. There's a nice little number there with my name on it. I'm going to take advantage of my Christmas bonus.
Oh, yeah. Last year, we got £200 each as our Christmas bonus. Paid for all my Christmas bits and bobs.
Didn't you get your letters?
Obviously not.
Due to the recession, there will be no Christmas bonus. It's either Christmas bonus or...
Surely they wouldn't make you redundant just before Christmas.
This wouldn't have happened to Mr. Banks, eh? You knew the Trevor tradition and loyalty. Come on, girls. Let's get going before they change their minds and put us back to work. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be part of this change. Christmas isn't the same anymore. Not since they put X Factor on the weekend telly.
Thank you.
sticks around in the kitchen. Mince pies!
So Merry Christmas this is turning out to be.
Now what's wrong? You've had a face like a smack backside. All day.
I wanted to go to a pantomime this year, but John Edlitson said the missus who said there was far too much work to do. What's Santa's wife called? Mrs. Santa?
No. Merry Christmas.
Did I hear my own name mentioned?
His name isn't Rudolph, ma'am. It's Cupid.
Oh, yes, of course. Thank you for reminding me.
Is there something funny?
They are stupid names.
Stupid names? And stupid Cupid.
Thank you.
to change everything back, including Mrs. C's mind about Christmas.
Well, this is the season of magic and surprises.
I know what I can do. I can tell some jokes.
What, like, why does Santa wear a red coat? Because his blue one's in the cleaners.
Hey!
hear me pretend, hoping not to play it.
I remember my first present my husband gave to me. It was an empty box.
An empty box?
Yes, my husband said he couldn't find a big enough box to put all his loving for me. So he gave me a little box. So wherever we roamed, wherever we went, I knew what I had to do was open the box to be reminded of all his love for me.
That's adorable!
Not everyone's quite that thoughtful. Do you remember Mrs. Craddock's mulled wine?
Oh, Fanny!
Traditional mulled wine. 1 liter of random red wine. I am reluctant to recommend a specific kind. Just remember, you're not trying to spoil anyone. Go for something with a screw lid, or better still, something in a plastic bottle. With a name that sounds vaguely Eastern European. Two liters of water. There's not a lot to be said about water. Unless you live in the docking area. In which case, good luck. 1 orange stuck with cloves. I'm assuming this means cloves of garlic. Miscellaneous fruits, oranges, lemons, tomatoes, whatever. Four tablespoons of sugar, or equivalent of sucrose, sorbitol, hermaphrodite, sweetex, etc. One small licorice stick. A slightly larger cinnamon stick. And the blooming great stick you used to play fetch with Fifi. Two teaspoons of fresh or ground ginger. Or a medium slice of McVitie's ginger cake. Generous splash of your favourite liqueur, creme de menthe, would be good. Be aware that Cointreau provides too sympathetic a flavour for your needs. Instructions. One. Limbo under the dining room table.
snowy outside?
Did you hear the joke about the snowman?
No, what was it?
It was even cold.
Oh. Oh. Or, what did the snowman say to himself while he was dancing?
Snow,
snow,
stick,
and
snow!
Say to his mother if he kept, she gave him a violin.
Oh,
fiddle!
Fiddle? I was gonna say fiddle.
What are you gonna ask the boss for Christmas?
Yeah, what are you gonna ask him for, Mrs. C?
If I was to tell you that, then it wouldn't be a secret, and we all know you two can't keep secrets.
still heating. So, there's no need for him to go up on them roofs, let alone come down on them chimneys. And not only that, but I have to fill all that paperwork in. You haven't got a clue what I have to do. And that health and safety officer doesn't have a clue. Don't understand. And not only that, me and my husband are getting far too old for this sort of worry.
I don't see Sandra and Mrs. C's being out. Heard you see him as? Well, Sandra and Mrs. C.
How old even are they now?
Well, my great 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 granddad said to me that they'll do the same thing when she has a little boy.
You must be very frustrated, especially when you've been doing the same thing year after year, only to be told you can't do it anymore.
Yeah,
Christmas just wouldn't be the same without them.
Too sexy for my room, too sexy for my room, too sexy for this room.
Too right. Would you believe it? They've gone and put up them there prices again.
Yeah. Worth it though, worth it.
Yeah. You're educated and all that. I mean, you've got knowledge. I mean, can you tell me why Christmas always comes when the shops are so crowded? I mean, I reckon I must be a claustrophobic.
How do you mean?
Well, Santa scares the life out of me.
I see what you're getting at now. Yeah. To be honest, Sid, Christmas is like any other in the warehouse. You and me, we do all the work, and I mean all the work. And inside that bloke, person, takes all the credit.
Yep. I know what I'd do if I was Santa.
What would you do?
Well, I wouldn't have a not naughty and nice list. I'd have a stupid list.
Stupid?
Yeah. Anyone send anyone want a request for anything over 25 quid, I'd send it back. Stamped and labelled. Bring on.
Hang on, I've got something even much better. You leave the present along with a hefty bill for shipping and handling.
What are you doing this Sunday?
Going to church. To avoid the Christmas rush. That's reminded me, Sid. I read the other day that apparently there was actually four wise men.
Three.
Four. On the way to Bethlehem, one of them knew a shortcut.
Well, I just hope I don't get another watch for Christmas.
Hey, I got one, look.
Nice, isn't it, eh?
Relax.
Yeah, too right. Get another one, be right confused.
Yeah. I can't be bothered with watches myself. I like to do things in my own time. Take last year, as a matter of fact. And while Vera was asking why Father Christmas was taking care for such a long time, I told her he was having a rest. A Santa pause.
I wish I'd get away with that.
It's a skill, Sid. So long as you tell the missus she's beautiful, she'll overlook most anything. And besides, I'm happy to live in a free country where a man can do as his wife pleases. And on that cheery note, we better scrap her. I don't have to explain any of this. Go on, first round on me. Wait.
December evening, when all the trees are bare, the sky is dark but Christmas lights are shining everywhere. So many colours on each house, twinkling as you pass them by. But when a home's in darkness, it makes you wonder why. Is near. Yet in the festive atmosphere, we forget to live in fear. For them it's just another day where bad times stay the same. You feel a little guilty, but you know you're not to blame. It's like to celebrate. And With a little care and time, things will turn out great.